Hey there, abiding fam, and welcome back to my channel, or hello if you're new. My name is Kelsey Lee, and I am so excited for this video and just for the season that this video always seems to represent for me. It is officially fall here in the Northern Hemisphere, which means pumpkins and fall leaves, and in my opinion, it means staying at home. I love just getting to cuddle up in my home and making it really cozy when it starts to get cold outside. So this month is all about that theme of let's stay home. Now, before we really delve into this theme and start creating some of these spreads, I do want to give a quick shout out to this video's sponsor, which is Skillshare. Now, I've worked with Skillshare in the past because I really believe in their mission of just making creativity accessible to the masses through online classes and an online learning community. And their classes range from watercolor courses to classes on how to develop your writing. Truly, there's something for everyone, and I'm going to let you know how you can get access to those courses for free for 2 months, so stay tuned. Speaking of writing, I am also collaborating on this video with Natalia Lee. She is an authortuber and by far one of my favorite YouTubers. I make sure to watch all of her videos. She is the author of Song of the Dryad, which is the perfect fall read. She also offers different author services, and every year she puts out this amazing Preptober workbook. The idea of Preptober is to get ready for National Novel Writing Month, which is in the month of November, but truly this workbook is so helpful for a writer at any stage. And so in our videos, both of us are going to be creating spreads with this theme in mind of kind of cozy writer stay at home, and using my printables, which are based on the design of her Preptober workbook, so they kind of work together. And that's basically the idea of our collaboration. So I encourage you to please go and check out her video next. You won't regret it. She did a fantastic job in her plan with me, and I know you'll enjoy getting to see her process. So in these spreads, I'm not only going to be using my printables as sort of the theme throughout, but also my new foil quill pens, which I'm going to talk about more a little bit later, but hold tight because they are awesome. So here we are. I am creating a quote page for next to my cover page. And of course, the quote, as you guys saw in the beginning, has to be, "Ain't nobody like a homebody." Because I just thought, I don't know, that quote just instantly came to mind when I was thinking of this theme of staying at home and being cozy and just envisioning myself sitting on my couch with my laptop writing away. So I pulled out my Tombow Fudenosuke pen and got to hand lettering with this quote. And I decided sometimes it's neat to just add in straight lines. It's amazing how that pulls it together. So I did do that for that, and I'm going to go back to it again with this foil. Now the foil quill pen, guys, is from We Are Memory Keepers. I will have it linked down below for you. And essentially the idea is that this foil is heat sensitive, and you plug this pen into a USB drive and it heats up the pen. And then as you go over the foil, so you're just writing as you normally would, it transfers the foil onto your page, and it doesn't burn or do anything bad to your bullet journal spread. I know everybody's like very precious about their pages in their bullet journal. It doesn't show through the back or anything like that. It just adds this absolutely beautiful foil to your page, and I am obsessed with the look of it. As you can see, I am just killing this little sheet of foil. I'm making sure I get every little bit of gold off of it as I possibly can because it is just so beautiful. So I went and, of course, wrote October 2019 because that is the month for this plan with me. And then I went and put little leaves on the trees. I thought that was just a really nice touch. And it shows you how you can make printables and things that maybe somebody else creates, like a sticker, a printable, a washi tape, and you can do something unique with it and be creative and add your own touch to it. So don't think just because you are using somebody else's design that you're not being creative, because where you put it on the page and what you put around it and how you embellish it, all of that is exploring your abiding creativity. And so I always try to stress that for you guys, that it doesn't have to come totally from scratch with a blank paper and a pen in your hand, and that's the only way to actually express creativity. There's a lot of different ways that you can. And for me, I think this was just a fun way to push things a little bit further. So that is the finished design, everybody. I am obsessed with the way it turned out. It's very simple, but at the same time, very involved, and I love it. So I personally am obsessed with the look of using foil now in my bullet journal. I know that's a little bit, like I said, more involved. Involved is apparently my word of the day, than most people maybe are used to using in their bullet journal. But let me know in the comments, you know, what sorts of things do you use in your bullet journal? Are you just strictly pen to paper, or do you play around with stickers and watercolors and just other mediums in your bullet journal? Let me know. Speaking of watercolors and different mediums, I did mention earlier that that is actually how I create my printables. I've been having so much fun exploring watercolors again and just playing around with that medium. And Skillshare has been a huge part of that for me, because there are so many classes on there for watercoloring that I was able to just watch a few and kind of just get some tips to delve back into that world, because I haven't been there for a little while. So I kind of just plop myself in front of the TV and sit down with my watercolors, and that is how I created these printables for you guys. So I make my little watercolors, and then I have to upload them to my computer, and then I rearrange them and just play around with the colors and everything in Photoshop before I finally have my finished product of the printables. It is a very involved, there's that word again, process, but it is so worth it because I love the way that these printables turn out. And if you are interested in getting them, they are available on my Patreon page. They are on the $6 tier. You get all three because I really wanted to offer different sizes of each of the illustrations, as you can see there. So you'll get all three. And then if you want a smaller version of this printables, there is one on the $2 tier as well, if you don't want to make quite the same commitment. And when you join, you don't only get access to these printables, but also every printable I've ever created. So if you look back through a lot of my plan with me's, I've used other printables in the past. They are all available on my Patreon, so you can go and check them out there. So I hope you guys really enjoyed these printables this month. I really feel that they are some of my best work. I was super proud of them. And part of that is because I was able to further develop my skills with Skillshare. So if you have a creative interest, or if you have multiple creative interests and you want to just dabble in all of them, I highly recommend you check out Skillshare. The link is down below. And the biggest thank you, guys, to my patrons for making this all possible. So here we are, guys, on kind of the main part of the plan with me, which is always my calendar spread. And this calendar spread, I once again decided to just do the vertical layout in writing in all of my to-dos. You can see down there, I put in at the bottom a big sticker to kind of block out the last week of October, because that is the week we are going to the Outer Banks as a family. So I have that in there. But other than that, it's just all of my different to-dos throughout the month of October. So, you know, going to Bible study or some different trips we have planned, like rock climbing with some friends. That is all there in the calendar, and of course there is room to add more things as well. But the real gem, as you might remember from that little sneak peek photo at the beginning of this plan with me, is these weeklies. So I decided that I would try my hand again at doing sort of a Dutch door type of weekly setup like I did last year for October as well, which you should go and check that video out if you haven't already. If you're new to my channel and haven't seen that one, there's a lot of great spreads in there as well that are also related to a autumn cozy writer theme. So make sure you check that out. But this year I wanted to change it up. So typically in a Dutch door type spread, you are just trimming down the edges of the page, all of them being totally even, so that you basically have a little booklet inside of your existing booklet. And if you want to see what that looks like I said, you can check out my October 2018 setup. But this year, what I wanted to do is more so create this effect where each successive page is longer than the previous one, so that when the front is closed on the weeklies, you can see a little bit of each successive one. So it kind of acts like a tab with each weekly being able to be seen so that you see where each one is and you can flip to it automatically. I just thought that would be a really cool effect, and I really love being able to see all of the printables at once. I think it makes this really cool. It just looks cool. It's just a cool effect. That's all there is to it, guys. And so as you can see, what I meant was is I just organized my printables in a way that the way where I would write the weeks would go in ascending order so that it would have this effect once again of being able to see each one. And I just wanted it to look like tabs. So the same way you have tabs organized in a binder, for example, I wanted that same look here in my bullet journal for each of the weeklies. So as you can see there, it looks so cool when they're all standing up. And obviously, that means that your first week is going to have less room than your last week. That's okay for me this month. I actually will have more to do later in the month. But essentially, I just wanted a big blank page for each week where I could just write general to-dos for the week rather than making it based on each day. Maybe not for everyone, but I had a lot of fun creating it, and I think it'll work really well for me this month. So let me know if you will try doing something like that this month or in the future. I would be very interested to know. And if you've ever tried a Dutch door, let me know that as well. So obviously now I have moved on to my fall TBR page because we are now moving into more of my collection type spreads for the month. So I really wanted to have a spread where I could track just some books that I want to read because I feel like I haven't been reading as much as I would like to recently. I've just been very busy. So I need to obviously have a page for it in my bullet journal to make sure I stay on track. So I just made it very simple with using stickers for TBR and then did fall using my combo dual brush pen. And then of course put in some of those illustrations and those printables down on the page as decoration because there's some really fun ones related to reading, including this little bookcase and then the armchair. And I couldn't create a TBR list and not share a few clips of my bookshelves, so I did throw those in here as well. And of course, I also wanted to point out that if you're not aware, I am an author, which is why I do all of these writing spreads. I have written two novels, If I Fall and If I Resist. They are the first two in the Circle and Cross trilogy, and I will be using Natalia's workbook to help me finish the third one because it absolutely needs to happen. And as you can see there, I also have Natalia's book, Song of the Dryad, on my TBR because I hear it is the perfect read for fall. So if you want a book to really set you in this season, make sure you pick up a copy of her book. So now let's talk a little bit about that writing process and a little bit more about the Preptober workbook. Now, I obviously am not starting a novel from scratch like most people are for National Novel Writing Month, but truly this resource is helpful for any writer at any stage. I am going to be using this page right now to develop a writing routine, which, by the way, Natalia, I do not have nearly enough free time to answer your question on that page. Natalia poses a lot of really good questions, and that is definitely not the answer she was looking for. But she has all of these great questions to help a writer develop a routine. So I went through and answered those, and then I created a tracker in my bullet journal to help me figure out what would be my best writing routine. So what I did is I mostly just used printables to decorate the page. And then in the middle, I have a week from Monday through Sunday, because that's how I like to set up my weeks. And then I divided each day into AM and PM because those are basically the times that I have available to write. Obviously, Saturday and Sunday, I have a little bit more, but mostly I need to get my writing done either before work or after work. And so I'm hoping I can use this tracker to figure out when that is with the help of Natalia's great questions as well. So that is the final spread that I created for my October setup and for Preptober. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please give it a thumbs up. Answer some of those questions I posed to you in the comments down below so we can engage a little bit more as a community. And then, of course, go over and support Natalia's channel. Check out her video. She is so close to 10,000 subscribers, and I would love for our Abiding Fam to help her get there. Speaking of this Abiding Fam, make sure that you join us by hitting that subscribe button. I would love to have you here for future videos. As always, guys, keep exploring your Abiding creativity. Remember to check out that Skillshare link. It's a great way to continue exploring. And I will see you guys in the next one as we continue to document a life full of abiding joy, faith, and love.